Welcome to Thoroughbred Action at Gulfstream Park. I'm Katie Stazak. Happy Saturday and happy Stakes Day. We have a great 10-race card on tap here at Gulfstream, highlighted by the third race, the Miss Patty Handicap for fillies and mares, going a mile and a 16th on the turf course. It's going to be an exciting day. Let's get right to the track and weather conditions. The main track is fast and the turf course is firm this Saturday. The first race on the card is a $6,250 claimer. Three-year-olds and up, which have not won three races, will be sprinting 6 furlongs on the main track. Scratch the 2, Forest Friends.
Racing at Gulfstream. Toward the inside, Acapulquito begins the best and goes looking for the lead. T's two-step is showing speed. Potashan up on the outside, so it's Potashan and Acapulquito, the top two in the rundown, the backstretch. It's a stretch of 3 to T's two-step. Racing on fourth is Red Max. Gap of another 3 to the team at the back, including My Uncle Charlie on the outside, Bellstorm, and from between them, DNA Approved. They pass the half-mile pole, chasing the speed of Acapulquito, and Manny Aguilar leads it 3 parts of a length. Potashan on the outside is racing in second, 3.5 lengths better than T's two-step. Step then Red Max, followed by My Uncle Charlie from the outside. Bellstorm needs to get a move on, and DNA Approved is from between them with 5/16 to go. Potashan bids up on the outside of Acapulquito for the front. 3 lengths more to T's two-step then Red Max. Not much change in the plot with 1/4 mile left to go. They won an opening half mile in 45-1, and on the outside, the leader is now Potashan, moving away by 2. Back to second is Acapulquito with T's two-step Red Max, and on the inside, My Uncle Charlie. Final furlong, Potashan on a 3-length lead. T's two-step looks to catch Acapulquito for second, but he will not catch Potashan. Potashan and Jonathan Gonzalez, 6-1 winners. They report home 3 lengths to the good. T's two-step second from Acapulquito third, and Red Max fourth and 1-11-1.
Potashan draws up handily to take the Saturday opener. Jonathan Gonzalez was the winning jockey for trainer Angel Rodriguez and owners AR Stable 3 LLC. Potashan paid $14.40 to win. That'll take us right to the second race, a $6,250 claimer. Three-year-olds and up, which have not won 2 races or three-year-olds, will be going a mile on the main track. Scratch the 6, Some Midnight Star.
They're off. From the outside, JC Universal begins the best. Here's Private Journal in the center showing speed, and up the inside lane, Mr. Kitten wants to be part of the party. Also away in the top flight is Cooley Quataka. So as they leave the chute, it will be Cooley Quataka who comes on now to take the lead from Private Journal away second. Furious Shot sets up shop third, a neck better than the gray Manny Blue Boy, who's now fourth. Mr. Kitten and on the outside, Open Throttle, 5th and 6th. And the 7th and last runner is JC Universal, who does his best running later. He's about 9 lengths behind after the opening quarter went in 23-4. At 5-1, Cooley Quataka and Edgar Zayas make the tone by 1.5 lengths, almost 2 now. Private Journal is there second, 3.5 lengths better than Furious Shot third with 5 furlongs to run. 1.5 lengths better than Mr. Kitten with Open Throttle on the outside. Second last is Manny Blue Boy and 5 more to JC Universal. Past the half mile and taking it to the far turn, they went a 46-4 half mile, and Cooley Quataka still has the lead. Private Journal is second for Sudeen with Furious Shot now asked to do some running third, but gaining a bit of ground. 3 in front of Mr. Kitten, Manny Blue Boy on the outside of Open Throttle, and they run to the top of the stretch. Zaya sitting motionless on Cooley Quataka, who arrives at the quarter pole on a 3-length lead and went 3/4 and 1:11-4. Furious Shot put to the whip ride. Manny Blue Boy is next. JC Universal unwinding from the back. 3/16 to go. Cooley Quataka now shaking up for the drive. Furious Shot takes a run at the leader and starts to gain ground late. Here's on the outside Furious Shot to take a run at Cooley Quataka. Cooley Quataka digging, but Furious Shot is reaching, and Furious Shot's got him now. Furious Shot delivers the money by almost 2. Second, Cooley Quataka, then Manny Blue Boy and JC Universal in 1:38-4.
Furious Shot gets the win in the second race. Jesus Rios was aboard for trainer Dario Vega and owner Sergio Vega. Furious Shot paid $4.40 to win.
Point of entry would not be denied. And they're into the stretch.
Point of entry's taking the lead.
Point of entry, a 2-length lead.
It's point of entry taking the lead.
Point of entry will go to the Breeders'
on
Cup.
On a 5-race winning streak.
5-time Grade 1 winner from a deep Phipps family with the pedigree and physical to become the heir of Dinah Former, Point of Entry, standing at Adena Springs.
The third race is today's feature. It's the $60,000 Miss Patty, an overnight handicap for three-year-old fillies. They'll be going a mile and a 16th on the turf course. Scratch the two, Great Majestic.
Racing in the Miss Patty overnight handicap. Cosmic Harmony timed the break perfectly and goes out to take the early lead. From the inside, Susie B will keep her spot, but she's a bit keen while second. Up on the outside, Leica Queen is now third. Stretch of three lengths to a Fleet Mary with Westminster Road on her inside, and the early trailer is the Panamanian Invader, Eminencia, as they run around the first turn. They're chasing the speed of Cosmic Harmony and Jose Caraballo. They've established a clear early lead by 2.5 lengths to the gray Susie B, who races in second. On the outside, Leica Queen is now third, three lengths better than Westminster Road, fourth, and about six lengths behind. To her outside is a Fleet Mary and the trailer, Amenencia. They went through the opening quarter in 24-4. Down the backstretch they go. Cosmic Harmony controls the pace and leads it by 3.5. Susie B is her nearest pursuer, second. Here's Westminster Road moving through on the inside to get into third. In front of Leica Queen, fourth. Amenencia has now moved up to be fifth, riding the rail, and trailing is the gray of Fleet Mary. Less than half a mile to go, they take it to the far turn. Cosmic Harmony does it well, leads it 3 parts of a length after a 48-4 half mile. Here's Susie B and Gaffalione turning up the pressure second, but as soon as he got to the leader's throat latch, she quickened again, so Cosmic Harmony's in front. Susie B is second, Westminster Road third, a Fleet Mary is asked to run from fourth. Leica Queen is outpaced, and Amencia is last of all as they run to the top of the stretch. Cosmic Harmony, well rationed by Caraballo, continues to be hounded by Susie B. 3/4, 1:12 and 3 in the wrap. The top of the stretch. Cosmic Harmony set down driving with a length and a half lead. Here's Westminster Road on the outside coming after the leader, and here's Westminster Road to get to Cosmic Harmony. Cosmic Harmony digging in, but Westminster Road going 2 to her 1, and Westminster Road and Edgard Zayas spring the upset. Cosmic Harmony second, Susie B third in front of a Fleet Mary fourth in 1:42. Flat.
Westminster Road runs down the favored Cosmic Harmony to take the Miss Patty handicap. She makes it back-to-back wins for trainer Marty Wolfson and owners Miller Racing, LLC. Westminster Road was ridden to victory by Edgard Zayas. She paid $11 to win. On to the fourth race now. This is an allowance with an optional claiming tag of $16,000. Billy's and Mare's three-year-olds and up will be sprinting 6 furlongs on the main track. Scratch the two, Little Daniela.
And they're up. From the center, Moment of Delight wins the break. Down to the inside, Emerald Citadel is showing speed. Silver Fog comes away in the top flight. She's third. The heavy favorite Colt Classic is on hold for Prado, racing fourth, pocketed up and two behind. Stretch of three lengths then to Midnight Dream, and the trailer is Premier Dame. Down the back stretch they go, and with the lead, Longshot Emerald Citadel, 3 parts of a length. They're controlling this early pace. Racing second is Moment of Delight. They went the quarter in 22-3. Silver Fog is on the outside, third. Colt Classic on hold, still no place to go. Racing fourth, keen to do it, too. 3 lengths from the lead. 3 lengths more to Midnight Dream, and the trailer is Premier Dame. They run around the far turn at the 5/16. Up on the outside, Silver Fog and Moment of Delight take shots at the leader, Emerald Citadel. Now working off the fence for a clear shot is Colt Classic. 2.5 lengths better than Midnight Dream, and the trailer is Premier Dame. And they're at the top of the stretch, and they line up 4 across the racetrack. Into the stretch, Moment of Delight now has to quicken up and gives up everything she has. From the outside, Colt Classic is trying to get after. Silver Fog and Emerald Citadel are next. Midnight Dream unwinding from far back. Deep stretch, Moment of Delight is strong, and Moment of Delight, she comes back a winner. Wins it by a length and a quarter. Colt Classic second, Emerald Citadel third. Close for fourth, Silver Fog or Midnight Dream.
Moment of Delight returns from a 2-month freshening to score a strong length and 3/4 victory in the fourth race. Juan Leyva was aboard for trainer Bill Kaplan and owners Pinnacle Racing Stable LLC and Norman Stables LLC. Moment of Delight paid $13.20 to win. The fifth race is a maiden special weight. Three-year-olds and up will be going a mile and a 16th on the turf course. Scratch the 10, Overseer.
They're off. Toward the inside, First Place Flirt gets the first call at the rail. Thunder Basin has speed, and the three path is over the limit, showing foot. Up on the outside, that's My High Roller. These four are quickest. From behind the speed, Giant's Passion is trying to tuck over with Highland Warrior and Major Anthem on the inside. The early trailers are True Diplomacy and Boca Scuttlebutt. They run around the first turn, separated by 6.5 lengths, and Thunder Basin has the lead by a length and a quarter. Up on the outside, first place Flirt is now second. Major Anthem is third while on hold. From the outside over the limit. Then it's a length to Highland Warrior to his outside. My High Roller toward his inside is True Diplomacy. Second last on the outside to Giant's Passion in the trailer, Boca Scuttlebutt. They move through the opening quarter in 23-3, and the leader is still Thunder Basin, a half a length. Over the limit, three wide second. From the inside, now moving up a bit, is Major Anthem. He's inside of first place Flirt. Up on the outside is My High Roller. From the inside, True Diplomacy. Then Giant's Passion, he's covered ground. Highland Warrior on hold between them, and Boca Scuttlebutt trying to unleash from the back after a 47-3 half mile. They run around the far turn. On the inside, Thunder Basin, moving up on his outside, is over the limit. Giant's Passion is now swung into action, and Giant's Passion is coming on as they run around the far turn. Over the limit just took the lead. Giant's Passion on the outside is second. Then from the between horses, Highland Warrior, Boca Scuttlebutt trying to get underway with My High Roller. Still nothing decided here. In fact, it's wide open. Top of the lane, Giant's Passion just ran up to take the lead. Highland Warrior trying to get after him second. Thunder Basin third. Boca Scuttlebutt at over the limit. Final furlong, still Giant's Passion. Two-length lead. Highland Warrior is second. He's gaining ground, but not enough to catch Giant's Passion. Giant's Passion, the winner by two. Highland Warrior second. Boca Scuttlebutt third. My High Roller and True Diplomacy in 142-2.
Giant's Passion prevails in the fifth race. Jonathan Gonzalez gets his second win of the day. This one's for trainer Terry Pompey and owners Patricia Generazio and Helen Barbazon. Giant's Passion paid $5.40 to win.
There's a new day dawning in Florida. Never before has a Breeders' Cup Classic winner retired to stud in the Sunshine State. Until now. Adina Springs presents three-time Grade 1 winner and earner of over $4 million, Fort Larned. New to Adina Springs South.
OBS, the two-year-old source. 17 OBS sales graduates and counting have won graded stakes in 2015, including Grade 1 winners Carpe Diem and Jack Milton. Don't miss the next opportunity to purchase a quality two-year-old at the OBS June sale, the sale that produced two-time Breeders' Cup Mile winner Golden Sense and Florida Horse of the Year Wildcat Red. Over 1,100 two-year-olds and horses of racing age will be offered. OBS, we measure success by performance.
The sixth race is a $6,250 claiming event. Three-year-olds and up will be going 7 furlongs on the main track. Scratch the One Bluegrass Derby.
And they're up. From the outside, Smoking the Field begins the best. From the center, moving to challenge now, Beantown Skipper. Up the inside, Feels Like Flying. It's Time to Laugh emerges as they run out of the chute. The early trailer is Be a Bull. Out of the chute and onto the main course. From between horses, Headstone puts ahead in front. Feels Like Flying is second. Houston Bull is now third. It's Time to Laugh on the outside, fourth. Toward the inside, Be a Bull improves inside of Beantown Skipper, and the trailer is Smoking the Field. Down the backstretch they go, and they approach the half-mile pole. Headstone leads it by a neck. Feels Like Flying right back at him second. Houston Bull is perched off the speed third. Beantown Skipper is no place to go from fourth. From the outside, it's Time to Laugh. Along the inside, it's user Be a Bull, and the trailer is Smoking the Field, but he's only 5 behind as they run around the far turn. They carved an opening quarter in 22-4, and there's 3 furlongs left to go. Half mile and 45-4. Up and on the outside, here comes a run from It's Time to Laugh to get to Houston Bull, who just took over. Beantown Skipper loaded, needs some place to go. He's slowly working off the fence for a clear shot. Be a Bull is under pressure, and he's not responding. Top of the lane, It's Time to Laugh, 25-1, and up for a short lead. Houston Bull battles back second. Beantown Skipper into the clear from third, and Be a Bull continues to chip away on the outside. Final furlong, 4 chances on the outside, and Beantown Skipper for the front. It's Time to Laugh battles back, and Be a Bull is resurgent and coming on. It's going to be close. It's going to be Beantown Skipper. Beantown Skipper and Gaffleone prevail narrowly from Be a Bull, who's in a photo for second with It's Time to Laugh, and Houston Bull fourth and 124 flat.
Beantown Skipper splits horses and gets up for the win in the sixth race. Tyler Gaffleone was the winning jockey for trainer Tamara Levy and owners IAB Stables. Beantown Skipper returned $20.40 for the victory. Let's get to the seventh race. This is a maiden special weight. Two-year-old fillies will be sprinting 5 furlongs on the main track. Scratch the 6, Agua Kate.
And they're up. From the inside, Star Millie begins the best. I'm a Tornado in the center is showing speed. Moving up on the inside, that's Off the Tracks to be third. From Go, Row, Row, Go, who was away racing fourth. A Song Memory is next from the outside unknown. 2 lengths better than Katir Rock with Stacy's Reflection. And the early trailer is Cape Magic. They run around the far turn toward the inside, Star Millie toward the outside. I'm a Tornado. They're in lockstep, racing up on the outside, now trying to split horses and doing just that is Off the Tracks. Off the Tracks is bullishly between horses to take the lead. Star Millie goes right with her second from I'm a Tornado, is trying to get out while third. Toward the inside, Go, Row, Row, Go is now fourth, 2 lengths better than Unknown, then Song Memory, and they run to the top of the stretch. Up on the outside, it's Off the Tracks ahead in front. Star Millie tries to battle back second, 4 lengths better than Go, Row, Row, Go, who's racing third. Unknown is next with Katira Rock putting in a run. In deep stretch, Off the Tracks is moving clear. It's Off the Tracks and Edgar Zayas moving clear to win it by 3.5, 4 lengths. Star Millie second, Katira Rock finished with good energy to be third in front of Go, Row, Row, Go. She was fourth in 58-3.
Off the Tracks kicks clear to take the seventh race, breaking her maiden in her career debut for trainer Roderick Rodriguez. Edgar Zayas gets his second win of the day for owners Jay Stables. The eighth race is a $12,500 claiming event. Three-year-olds and up, which have not won 2 races or three-year-olds, will be going a mile and a 16th on the turf course. Scratch both of your main track only participants in here. Those are the 11 and the 12.
And they're up. From the center, Bosco Bob's Baby wins the break. Ben Jacob from the outside. Unsaintly is showing speed, and You Are So Perfect is keen to go. The gray Zen Imperialism comes away in the top flight, and also away in the top flight is Indigo Devil. Ben Jacob's going to be hung out very wide as they hit into that first turn run. He's no less than 6 deep on that corner, trying to cross over with Zen Imperialism and Indigo Devil holding the inside position. Unsaintly is 3 wide. Now here's Ben Jacob trying to cross over. Racing up in fifth is Bosco Bob's Baby with You Are So Perfect next. City Robert is next, 3.5 lengths better than Havermeyer Street. Then to the outside of him and racing second last, Mace Away. The early trailer is Wise Maker. They move through the opening quarter in 23-4. Unsaintly decides to back off, so now it's a 3-headed duel. Zen Imperialism by a head, Ben Jacob 3 wide, Indigo Devil from between horses. Then to the outside, Unsaintly, he'll now tip 4 wide for a clear shot. Bosco Bob's Baby rides the inside. Then Mace Away and You Are So Perfect. He's shuffled a bit now. Plant City Robert is at the back with Wise Maker, and also in that top flight is Havermeyer Street. They're really taking closer order here. They're only separated by about 6 lengths as they take it around the far turn. They went a 48.5 mile. Zen Imperialism held together. 3 wide Unsaintly. Ben Jacob from between them. Bosco Bob's Baby and Mesa Way are next. Here's Havermeyer Street unleashing a wide run. He's about 5 or 6 wide, but he's coming on as they run to the top of the stretch. Zen Imperialism is in front. Here's Havermeyer Street, and on the far outside, Plant City Robert. This is completely up for grabs. And up on the outside, here's Havermeyer Street to the front. From the far outside, Plant City Robert begins to motor. Back third is Zen Imperialism, then Bosco Bob's Baby. In deep stretch, Havermeyer Street strikes the lead. Plant City Robert is up into second. Havermeyer Street, the winner. Plant City Robert, then Bosco Bob's Baby and Zen Imperialism in 143-3.
Havermeyer Street holds off the closers in the eighth race. Jermaine Bridgemahan was in the irons for trainer Howard Mills and owner Georgina Suki. Havermeyer Street paid $12 to win.
Close to home.
Welcome back. Let's get to the final two races of the day. The ninth race is a $10,000 maiden claiming event. Three-year-olds and up will be going a mile on the main track. No scratches or jockey changes to report.
And they're up. From the center, Drimmer is away the best and goes reaching out for the early lead. Drimmer will have an easy lead, it appears, with Criolla's Boy trying to press the issue in the early stages. These two are quickest from third. It's West Ride. Up on the outside, both Phils Comprise and Power away in the top flight. But as they run out of the one-mile chute, the odds-on favorite is clearly in front. It's Drimmer with a three-and-a-half-length cushion. Racing in second position is West Ride all the way on the outside, Gunther Brothers. Down to the inside, Criolla's Boy with Sniffer alongside. Then it's Power. Semper Curry is next with Phils Comprise, and Wild and Wild is last of all, and about 7 or 8 lengths off the speed of Drimmer. Drimmer carved a quarter in 24-1, has the lead by a length and a half. Racing second now is Sniffer. From the far outside, it's Gunther Brothers. Power is between horses. West Ride moves up on the inside in front of Criolla's Boy, then Wild and Wild and Semper Curry. The trailer Phils Comprise. They went a 47 4/2 mile. Spirited tempo for the level, and Drimmer is collared on the outside by Sniffer, who's 22-1. Sniffer moves away now from Drimmer, who's back to second. From the back, Phils Comprise starts to get underway. Wild and Wild held up in traffic with no place to go. As they run to the top of the stretch, Criolla's Boy also awaits racing room as Sniffer is still in front. Sniffer widens the advantage to 3 lengths from Drimmer second after 3 quarters in 113 flat. Wild and Wild swings wide for the drive with 5 lengths to make up and Sniffer to catch. Sniffer has the lead by 3. Wild and Wild on the outside now second. Criolla's Boy is now third, but the upset is on. It's Sniffer moving clear. Jose Alvarez springs to 22-1 shocker as Sniffer is in front by 5. Wild and Wild is second. Drimmer third from Criolla's Boy and 140-2.
Sniffer springs the upset in the ninth race. Jose Alvarez was aboard for trainer Antonio Machado and owners Mimai Trainer Services Corporation. Sniffer paid $47.80 to win. The 10th and final race on Saturday's card is a $12,500 maiden claiming event. Fillies and mares, 3-year-olds and up, will be going 7.5 furlongs on the turf course. A full field of 13 set to go to the post.
And runners away. Royal Spaces was a step slow and I presume checked back to last. Moon Solo Moon gets the first call. Moonlight Matinee moves to challenge and Lion Soul is away in the top flight. Wide on the course is Pat M's Image and Par 3 also comes away with speed as they negotiate the first turn. Adar sets up shop from fifth now. A length and a half back to Moon Solo Moon with Yes by Stormy. Bright Lady is next. To the outside, I'm Just Like You. From between horses, that's Annabella Hall. Stretch of 2 lengths to Cookie Exchange. The two trailers are Royal Spaces and from the outside, I presume. They bend into the backstretch after the open quarter went in 22-4. It's Moonlight Matinee in front now by 2.5. Par 3 is second. Pat M's Image on the outside third. Lion Soul fourth. Adar is now fifth. Yes by Stormy sixth. Seventh to the outside while 3 wide is Moon Solo Moon in front of Annabella Hall. Then it's Bright Lady. 3 more to the outside. The Gray Cookie Exchange, who's better than Royal Spaces at the back, I presume. And I'm Just Like You. That's the 13 of them as they run around the far turn after a half and 46-2. Stern tempo being set by Moonlight Matinee, who leads it by a length and a quarter. Pat M's Image is on the outside of Lion Soul, a joint second. Racing fourth and now coming off the fence is Adar. These top 4 have opened up 5 or 6 on Yes by Stormy and Moon Solo Moon, and they run to the top of the stretch. Moonlight Matinee still has the lead. Here's Lion Soul off cover to try to track her down, and here's Lion Soul to take the lead. Adar surfaces from the outside. Moonlight Matinee tries to battle back from the backfield. Annabella Hall with a late say. Final furlong, Lion Soul's in front. Moonlight Matinee coming back in second. Then Adar and Pat M's Image to the finish. Lion Soul the winner. Moonlight Matinee second. Pat M's Image third. Close fourth. Adar over Annabella Hall in 130-2.
Lion Soul gets the win in the 10th race, breaking her maiden in her second start on turf. Tyler Gaffleone gets his second win of the day. This one is for trainer Ralph Nix and owners Goldmark Farm, LLC. Lion Soul paid $4.80 to win. And here's how our exotic wagers paid today. The pick 4, 4 of 4, $773.60. The pick 5, 4 of 5, $66.50. 5 of 5, $20,550.65. There were 3 singles heading into the final leg of the Rainbow Six, but there was no single winning ticket. The Rainbow Six, 6 of 6 today, paid $26,101.24. There will be a carryover again into Sunday. That stands at $171,442.28.
That's going to do it for Saturday's card. We will cap our race week tomorrow on Sunday with 9 more races, including 2 strong turf allowances and another maiden special weight for the ever-promising 2-year-olds. That race will feature the well-bred Swamp Chili from the Stanley Gold Barn. He's a half-brother to Grade 1 winner Midas Eyes, and he's going to try the dirt for the first time tomorrow after disappointing in his career debut on the turf. We'll see if he likes the new surface tomorrow. That's just some of what to look forward to, so I better see you here for the whole day. First post is 1 o'clock p.m. Thanks for watching Thoroughbred Action at Gulfstream Park. I'm Katie Stazak.